speak often with Kanan.
You're asking me if I have a relationship with my brother, aren't you?
Yes. I wonder what he thought of you.
I don't think he cared much about my existence. I didn't mean anything to him. Anyway, to answer your original question, no. We never spoke. Well, maybe once. Marek and Kaelin had come to Redcliffe to visit the Arl. I was very young then. We were introduced. I believe I said, "Greetings, Your Highness." He said, "Ooh, swords," and ran off to the armory. So, yes, that was the extent of our relationship. We drifted apart after that. Very sad.
Like to buy something, I hope. I want that surface wealth coming back to us, Balin's ascension willing. I'll take your gold.
Let me guess. This is where the poor people live.
Who are you? You don't look like any guardsman I ever saw, and that's not much of a uniform. Oh, you looking for a chance to bring in some coin? Could be I have that opportunity, especially for someone with a few connections above ground. No offense, but your kings have some laws that don't make sense in a practical kind of world. Like about who gets to buy and sell Lyrian, the sacred gift the stone provides us to show her love. No law should regulate that. The laws are meant to keep mages away from the stuff, so there's always buyers in the Circle Tower. I got one man named Godwin. He's expecting a delivery of a stone's weight. You want an investment opportunity? I could see fit to, say, sell you that lyrium instead, at the reasonable price of 50 sovereigns. You can keep it, or, since you can travel freely from here, sell it to Godwin, who you know is buying. And if you bring back his return order, I could pay you, say, 20 sovereigns as a finder's fee. You haggle like a merchant born. Deal. Here's the lyrium, then. You, probably don't want to take it out of the box. I'll be waiting for the next order somewhere out of sight. Say, just around the corner. Well, if it isn't my new best friend. You make it to the tower yet? Pleasure.
What do you want, Warden? You're out of your element down here.
Is that so? What makes you think anyone here would turn me...
I mean this person in. You've walked into a sodding fight, Warden, and I've already passed your stupid tome along. Too bad for you.
Very well.
Done. Your clothes are so fancy. Did you get them topside? My mam used to say they don't got no stone to protect them topside. If I go up there, I'm gonna fall into the sky. Yes. When my Dot left, he never came back. Who's to say he didn't fall up, eh? Don't fall into the sky when you go back up there.
Well, look at that. It's not often old Nadezhda sees a fine-dressed stranger here in Dust Town. Help a poor cripple. Well, thank you truly, my lord. That's right good of you. It takes a stranger to notice how bad things are, huh? No dwarf would lift a sodding finger. Excuse my language. What takes you out of the Diamond Quarter, stranger? You got a vice you're looking for old Nadezhda to fill? I'd say it was an accident, try to get some sympathy coin. But you look like you'd rather hear the truth. I was running protection for the Carta when some guardsmen caught me. Duster I was with had coin for a bribe, but I took a stand. Guardsmen broke my sodding kneecaps and had me kneel in dung until the infection set in. Never healed proper. I don't know where you're from, but in Orzammar, castless have no lineage, so it's no crime to hurt you. You're born to wear a branded face in Orzammar, and you'll live your life in Dust Town. If you have that kind of coin, Salroka, you don't want to drink what they've got here. Take yourself up to Tapster's. Long as your face isn't branded, they've got anything you want. Means you don't exist. It tells everyone who sees you not to work with you, not to serve you, and not to care if you're hurt. The Deep Lords burn it into us the day we're born, so no one accidentally oversteps her place. I'll just stay out of your way then.
Spare a bit for the needy? Have you a coin to spare, my lord? It's for my son. He's sick. He hasn't any clean clothes to wear or anything to eat today. Neither have I.
A question I ask every day. He was eager enough for a daughter who would bring him into the mining caste. But since the boy was born, I've not seen nose or heel of the lout. And me alone on the street, forbidden to return to my family unless I... But no! I can't bear to even think of it! My son's father is castless, as is he. I used to be a miner, but my parents stripped my caste and refused to accept me back. Unless I agree to abandon the child in the Deep Roads and pretend I never bore him! In Orzammar, lineage is traced through the child's same-sex parent. Had my baby been a girl, she would have been a minor like me. But as a boy, my son is considered tainted forever by his father's seed. Yes, I can become castless with him, which is what I've done. Others have raised children like this, right? Begging for change, sleeping in doorways? I heard as much. There was a man speaking on the street, talking about the human religion. He called himself a cleric, said he could help me.
You would do that? But why?
Then I cannot offer enough gratitude. But I warn you, my father is a stiff-necked man. His name is Ordell, and he's usually at Tapster's in the evening. I do not think he will listen to you. But I will wait anxiously to see if you can do what you promise.
What are you looking at, stranger? I have no daughter. Could be you met a castless whore claiming she was once mine.
What? You think she'd die just to keep that thing?
She knows what she has to do to come home. I never wanted her gone.
Just the little cur. Can't she see she'd have a better life if she got rid of it?
Look, just tell her we never meant to hurt her. It just seemed best that...
Oh, just tell her to come home. Her mother and I are waiting for her.
I shall do it.
You're back. I thought you weren't coming. What did he say? Both of us? I don't believe he said that. I've never heard him refer to my son as anything but trash. He calls him it. But maybe. Maybe Mother convinced him. Or you did. Oh, my friend. I cannot thank you enough. If this were a story, my son would grow to manhood and pledge himself as a knight in your service. When he grows up, I will send him to you. I promise.
That Jarvi is a dangerous one.
You got a crust of bread to spare.
Let me get this straight. You were a cloistered sister?
You must have been a brother before you became a Templar, no?
I never actually became a Templar. I was recruited into the Grey Wardens before I took my final vows.
Do you ever regret leaving the Gentry?
No, never. Do you?
Yes. You may not believe it, but I found peace there. The kind of peace I've never known.
It used to get so quiet at the monastery that I would start screaming until one of the brothers came running. I would tell them that I was just checking. You never know, right?
No, I never did anything like that. I enjoyed the quiet.
Suit yourself. The look on their face was always priceless.
You decide to watch the fights then? It's announced when the fight begins. That's about all the warning anyone... I'm telling you, P.O.
We're opening the roster in a few hours.
If you're looking for seats, speak to Bob.
This is a private area. Combatant.
Go away. I don't talk to a fire.
Guards, remove this intruder. If you're looking for seats, speak with the doctor.
More enemies ahead. Now.
Begun.
Famous after all.
The stories I heard were a little racier. It had to do with how a bard assassinated her target, how they were lulled into complacency.
If those stories were true, who would ever agree to entertain a bard in their court?
Oh, I don't know. There's a certain allure to danger, isn't there? And besides, you couldn't all be assassins, could you? I'd take my chances. If the stories were true, that is.
We had rules about that sort of thing. Strict rules.
Such as? You're not gonna tell me, are you?
Let's just say I had plenty of reasons to join the Chantry, shall we? And leave it at that. It is sometimes so hard to believe that you have been through so much at such a young age.
I think I look younger than I am.
Yes, yes, that is possible. When I was your age, I was just about ready to take on my first apprentice. In hindsight, perhaps I should have waited a few more years. I was arrogant, my confidence bolstered by my youth.
It is so hard to imagine seeing you now.
Oh, I've had some 2 decades or so to grow mellow. Believe me, back then I was quite prickly.
So you are like a fine wine, yes? Losing the raw edges over time.
I suppose there is some truth to that analogy, but dear Maker, I do hate being compared to wine. Or cheese. Especially cheese.
Our tribe fights for you, Warden.
Very well. I shall do it.
Be glad to learn that the Circle is well on its way to recovery. Ozma, indeed. You have piqued my curiosity. It is common knowledge that dwarves lack the aptitude for spellcraft. She will never be able to weave the simplest magic, no matter how hard she tries. Fascinating. I suppose the Circle should be flattered. I see. If she is willing to sacrifice so much for this, then we should feel honored. Tell Dagna of Ozma that this path will not be easy. But if she chooses it, then she is welcome here at the Circle. She will live and study with the Tranquil, and perhaps the apprentices, when it is appropriate. Ah, if only the Circle was in better shape. I fear she may be disappointed when she arrives. This will be interesting. She could tell us much about our dwarven neighbors. Yes, the more I think about it, the more I like the idea. I shall take this as an indication that perhaps things are starting to look up for the Circle. Thank you. You've already done much for the Circle. Now, you must see to your duty as a Grey Warden. I wish you well. Know you will always be welcome here.
Do you think the tower is ever going to get back to what it was, Wynn?
I don't know. A great number of people died. It will be difficult to imagine rebuilding, with that cloud hanging over everything for many years to come.
Do you think you'll be there? To help rebuild, I mean, once this is all over with.
I cannot say. Even if I survive this blight, I am a very old woman, Alistair.
Why? Because of some grey hair? You are a formidable woman, Wynn. You could see that it happens.
I think you overestimate the number of years I have left. But perhaps you were right. Or perhaps the memories of what happened there will be too strong for me to face.
I have a hard time believing that.
Well, it's good to have someone that believes in me so. Now, if I could only feel the same way myself, that would be something.
Glad I'm still alive, but the Circle's future still remains to be seen.
Ah, hello again. Would you like me to tell you again how wonderful you are? Or maybe you'd just like to talk a little? Rogek? Well, he's a personal friend, and sometimes we, you know, correspond. Did he, have anything for me? Yes, yes, I'll take it off your hands right now. Ah, what about 50 sovereigns? That's a good price, no? Look, I have 65 sovereigns and this dagger I stumbled upon in the tower. Will that do? Done and done. You have your gold, and I have my lyrium. Everyone's happy. Out of curiosity, do you know why this lyrium took so long to get here? Dwarves and their politics. Always causing trouble. How is the situation now? Ah, I see. Well, I just wanted to know if I should expect another late delivery. Well, mages need lyrium for spells and things. Nothing you'd know about. All right, I'll tell you. Just keep your hands to yourself. Well, yes, but you see, the Templars use lyrium too. They cannot manipulate natural energies like mages can, but they need to be able to fight us. The big problem with lyrium is that it has diminishing returns, and the Templars become dependent on it.
You're taking advantage of the Templars, encouraging them. And for money, you despicable profiteering crook!
If it wasn't me and Rogek, someone else would do it. Those that know what I do have good reason not to get me in trouble. You can't do that. Gregor doesn't have time for trivialities. He's a busy man. Very busy. Oh, you'll do what you'll do, won't you? So just leave me alone.
So what do you think will happen to all those people we left behind in Lothering?
Some of them will find their way to Denerim. Many will die, as the Maker wills.
Don't you wish you could have stayed there? To help more people, I mean.
If the Blight isn't stopped, everyone will die. This is the greater good we're serving, both of us, right here.
So it's all right to let some people die for the greater good? I'm not so sure about that. I felt bad leaving all those people there, all panicked and helpless.
You're doing what you must, Alistair. There will be worse to come yet. You will need to steel yourself. You know this.
I've never been very good at that, the steeling myself part. I find it better sometimes to just be a little weak. I'm all right with that, really.
I don't believe you. And either way, it's not as if any of us has a choice.
My men have scouted the tower. It's a mess, but the abominations are gone. You are very thorough. I'm impressed. Where did you hear about this? I was not aware. Godwin. Yes, I know of Godwin. He intended to sell this lyrium to the Templars. Lyrium is dangerous. The Templars are only to use it at the command of the Chantry. I will seek out this Godwin and learn more about this. Well, I could hardly get a straight answer out of that man, what with all his begging and snivelling. But he has told me all about his lyrium smuggling racket. I must have been blind to not have noticed it. Thank you for bringing it to my attention. I shall have to find out which of my Templars has been purchasing this smuggled lyrium, of course. And then we will help them recover. I will definitely investigate this lyrium smuggling racket further. I will question my men as soon as I can spare the time. Thank you for bringing this to my attention.
Shall be done. It shall be done. Very well.
Our Leman sends his regards, Warden. We're trying to keep the roads clear and safe.
How can I... Oh, it's you! And it's been, well, quite a while. Enough time to get to the circle and back, I hope. Oh, please tell me what they said. Ancestors, bless you! I can't believe it! There hasn't even been a dwarven observer in the circle since Ureldon in the 13th century! I need to pack. No, my parents would get suspicious. I need to go! Is there anything I should bring? Books? Tuition? Then I should go before my parents come looking for me. If you ever go to the circle again, maybe I'll see you there.
Well, if it isn't my new best friend. You make it to the tower yet? Excellent. I must say I wasn't sure I'd see you back here. Now, that was 10 sovereigns we agreed to, right? Well, that seems pretty steep. I can't believe I'd offer that much. But I do appreciate what you did. I'm gonna give you 25, and let's call it even.
Didn't get enough of the architectural beauty of Dust Town? You need old Nadezda to play tour guide? I'll just stay out of...
What are you looking for? We got nothing to buy for the likes of you. Or maybe you wanted to sell. Well, our business is kind of covert, if you know what I mean. It's illegal in Orzammar for me to engage in protected trade, but they look the other way if I share things with my friends for money. Why don't you take a look?
Doing business with
you. You need me?
I remember when the Grey Wardens would visit.
Oh, the festivities we had. Those days are past. Could the end of Orzammar be nigh?
Lord Halamont is a...
You found it. Warden, you have my gratitude. You're a bright spot in an otherwise dark time. At least someone is willing to stand up for tradition. Thank you again.
Halamont is a
weak man, and he will be a weak king. Yes.
Lord Balin suspected of personally defacing statues of the Paragons. Shocking allegations abound.
You have come at a difficult time.
You're the best wrangler I've ever seen, but there's more out there. You're the best wrangler I've ever seen. You're the best, I trust Vala, my nug wrangling friend.
What's this? A human? Did we make these tunnels tall enough for humans? I'm sorry, but I cannot allow you past the front lines without Adesha's permission. And I've heard nothing of any new patrols scheduled to leave today. I see you have his daughter's seal, so I will not stop you. But be careful. Just because the beasts have pulled back from Orzammar doesn't mean there are any fewer in the Deep Roads. Either we finally have the edge, which I doubt, or the beasts are building up numbers for the next attack. Of course not. Down here, you're bound to run into giant spiders, deep stalkers, and other vermin. Ugly beasts they are. Walk on two legs, but they have the head of a worm and hunt in packs. Watch out. They're not afraid to take on a group their own size. A few outposts. Legion of the Dead, mostly. Fools that they are. Some scavenger types, too. It's an independent company of soldiers. They accept no command but their own. Anyone who can bear arms can join, no matter his crimes or sanity. They hold a funeral when they join and swear their only goal is a glorious death. Best of luck.